Okay, continuing my critical let's play of Modern Warfare 3. War in Europe started fully in the last mission with Frost, and now Price and Soap and Yuri are still trying to track down Makarov, and we got some intel from Price's friend in MI6. So while we're still off the grid, we're off trying to find the guy who got the chemical weapons to Makarov in Sierra Leone. Or maybe they didn't give them to him, but helped him smuggle them into Europe. I like how this mission starts quite suddenly, which is part of this kind of, you know, the way I keep saying this game hits every beat. The last mission finished with, you know, kind of saving the vice president. We have a little loading screen where we zoomed into this car. You know, the camera zoomed in down from the loading screen. And straight away we're in this car kind of... approaching this massive sandstorm in this town. Of course, our character gets up so we can actually see it ourselves, because this sandstorm becomes a big deal later in this mission. Yeah, got some dramatic music coming out. Nikolai comes in, blows up the tank for the gate for us. Another gate, so he just blows up people. So this mission just like jumps right into it. And then you see Price get out and just like headshot two people with his pistol, which, as I say, he keeps doing because he's a badass. The sniper rifle conveniently right here. So we're pretty much just trying to find this guy. We're not mucking around anymore. We're not doing specials. We're just like smashing through the front fence, which is so different of a way, you know, this squad usually does things in the previous missions. It's just kind of like, you know, screw it, we're just going to do this now. And we get a new toy. I say toy purposefully, since all these games are just kind of toy soldiers on an epic scale kind of thing. We have Nikolai's chopper, which we're looking out of. So Nikolai's flying around and we're just controlling the gun on it for him. I don't know why he doesn't just have a second person up there, but again, it just gives us another way to have multiple perspectives. So he keeps trying to get, he keeps setting up for passes while we go back to Yuri on the ground. Oh, I killed a good guy. Yuri has a much more stable weapon now, thankfully. So as I was saying, drastically different from the way this squad normally does things. You really feel like, if you're not getting towards the end of the game yet, definitely getting towards the end of the series, in a kind of aggressive, frustrated, this is it kind of way. Even this, just on a kind of, minor way is a nice kind of breaking up of the running and gunning as well. Like, it's just constantly changing things up on you. For all people who call this game repetitive, and it is, and deliberately so, it's got a really nice rhythm to it. A similar kind of rhythm that you see, you know, in Titanfall since it came out. You know, that kind of constant moving and bouncing around and stuff. Like, it's very easy to see Titanfall as kind of a continuation of this style of game. Even though, ironically, I guess, the Titanfall people weren't working in Modern Warfare 3 because they'd quit to go make Titanfall. But interestingly, the people who hung around or they got in to make this game, I feel, managed to figure out what they were trying to do in Modern Warfare 2 better than they could. Maybe because the new people weren't tied down to what Modern Warfare, what Call of Duty used to be. Just blatantly hypothesizing now, but... yet again, with Nikolai's helicopter going overhead, you know, you've got part of a roof conveniently taken out, so as you come up over the stairs, in this corridor, you see him fly over. just reminding us that Nikolai is still around, because that becomes important for the last half of this mission, kind of like the tanks were previously. So we're trying to find where Robby. Whoops. In hindsight, that's not very good cover.
Bravo 1, get in position. Flanking now. Multiple hostiles entering second floor room.
Where are you going, Price? Let's try to follow you. What the hell is that? Must be a machine gun or something.
Bravo 1, get in position. Flanking now. Multiple hostiles entering second floor room.
That was weird. I don't think I've ever had trouble there before. So another breaching moment, which you do a lot in this game. So you have him running away. Oh my god. Really not doing it right well. I think I did with going into my iron sights on the breach here, which I really gotta stop doing. So I like how you always give these kind of little slow motion cinematics while you're moving around. Like, you can't kill him, by the way, he just kind of trips over a box. So we all put our masks on.
Look familiar.
And Price decides to open up some of the same green toxic fumes that are all over Europe.
Where's Makarov? Tell me and it's yours.
Our contact with a man named Volk. We never met Makarov.
Where's this Volk?
These kind of scenes, like, I expect you to be standing in a particular place here just where you came in. And of course, if you stay there, you see the kind of scene in a certain way.
We're all be broke. We have what we need. Ready for exfil.
So just this kind of just rush through. You don't go out the same way you come in. You have this constant kind of moving forward. And you get more sense of, again, Price kind of off being off the rails. We're being reminded that there's a sandstorm coming, both by people on the radio, but also because it's right there in front of us, looming. So we have to get out of here. So there's Nikolai. Time to get out. I'm sure this will go perfectly fine. And then we get ambushed. The person who died there was a nameless soldier. Like, they always introduce these soldiers to have like one line of dialogue. If I can get in, you know, just so they can die. So they don't have to kill Soap or Price. So we're trying to get to another landing zone. I appreciate you don't have a lack of fuel thing here. But a different reason why you have to do it quickly. Not doing so well in this mission at the moment.
Let's go.
they don't have very long to do this part. I remember struggling quite a lot with it when I first did it, especially on hard. It was quite, I guess, kind of like Brazil. It introduces verticality and maybe way too many enemies, but still definitely didn't annoy me as much as Brazil bit. Essentially, any part that enters includes verticality and just a whole bunch of enemies in windows and doorways and rooftops. Just gets way too overwhelming way too quickly, I think. Or I suck. You know, it's also entirely possible. Don't normally suck this much, though. I really like the forewarning, of the sandstorms. You got everything blowing in the wind. It's conveniently telegraph wires everywhere, you know, and the trees. Like, it doesn't just hit suddenly, like, it builds up gradually, like, all these bushes, the grass, the sand. It does a really good job of just being like, this sandstorm is getting closer. I really appreciate that attention to detail, the shadows on everything. Reminds you of kind of, you know, when the winds pick up, when a storm's getting near. Which is, of course, exactly what's happening. So as you come here, it starts getting darker. Parts of a construction site fall down. You know, tarps blowing off boxes. This sandstorm is getting bad. So it's not good weather for a helicopter. Right there, right behind us. And then of course now the remote turret becomes very important. What was just kind of, but I have managed to kill myself doing that before. There's RPGs coming in. And then of course one hits him. And you're back here and the helicopter's coming right at you. I really like that moment as well. And of course that is the second the sandstorm hits and everything goes dark. And it's just so fluid, such a fluid kind of change from, you know, blue sky, running, gunning, getting out of here to pitch black, sneaking in to rescue him. But I like how when the missile hits him, you have that kind of, again, the game makes sure you're always there to see the action, you know, it makes sure you're there as, you know, on the remote camera so that you're in the helicopter when it gets taken out. As a perspective, if not as a body. And they have this like drastically different color palette with this kind of nearly impossible to see oranges and blacks. Like just for the way this mission kind of turns on a hinge there, I really appreciate. Of the lights, it's really interesting. You're kind of like in the end of Modern Warfare 1, you have a very convenient torches that turn off the moment you kill them. Which again, I really enjoy as a kind of just as a visual feedback thing, but makes no actual sense. So do that in your games. Enemies that carry flashlights that turn off the second you kill them. It's very, it makes it very pleasurable. And of course you've got the orange fire with the orange sand and the orange bullets, the orange torches. And again, another kind of hark back to the first Modern Warfare, saving someone from a helicopter crash. But hopefully this time we don't get nuked. You know, you turn around a second to see them all kind of pulling back, shooting over your head to remind you there's people still there. We just kind of throw Nikolai the mines there. And importantly, we don't pick him up at the bottom, which I really like. But you know, they give that to someone else, you've done your part. And then getting out of there. So we knocked down the front door, we took out where are we got a name that we're gonna go after, and we got out again. So it just kind of, you know, just flows through, like Price isn't taking any bullshit anymore, he's just taking names.
Caller, please authenticate.
Access code Black Viking. Get me a secure line to Asset Metal 01.
Price, thanks for the tip on Kingfish. You should know Uncle Sam's got a kill capture order on your head.
Tell him to join the bloody queue. Makarov's bomb maker, Volk, is in Paris. We need to act before he bolts and I can't make the window. You're the only one I trust with this.
I'm on it.
The bastard used Forgotten Industries as a front.
So Price and Sandman clearly know each other as well. Sandman being Frost's leader, which is convenient. GIGN tracked him deep behind enemy lines, but they're pinned. So we've just kind of passed on the information about Volk. And now we're going to go and try to capture Volk to see if he can get us any closer to Makarov.
This is Overlord Actual. Negative. All US forces in Paris are engaged. Triage the civilians and move your team.
See that really kind of harrowing voiceover as you come in, someone just wanting some support to help with civilians, and over the base plate is just like, no, it's not going to happen. We're not going to be saving any civilians. As they're kind of trying to give you a sense of, I guess, for desperation. And you have this mask on as well. To kind of make it clear that there's still poison everywhere. You know, this shit is just hanging here in all these cities. We're in Paris at the moment. And as you walk through here, your vision's kind of forced downwards, so you can see all the dead French civilians down there. You know, just to constantly remind you, in case you weren't listening earlier, that you know these entire cities have been destroyed by these chemical weapons of mass destruction. So we're trying to rendezvous some French forces. That we get attacked soon. I really like when first-person games kind of restrict your vision with, you know, oxygen masks or whatnot, like Metro 2033 does as well. That kind of constant hindrance on your vision to remind you that, again, that you have a body, essentially. We found the GIGN, the French. I think they're a police force rather than military, but we're trying to help. I don't know what GIGN stands for.
Seven men standing.
Where's Volk?
And they know where Volk is and we're trying to get to him.
We believe Volk is still there.
We got you six. Lead the way. Overlord, this is Metal 01. Link up complete. We're en route to the HVI's location now.
So now we're probably kind of circling the open area, moving from building to building. You have one of the same kind of chemical trucks as was in London. So we're clearly right at the center of one of the explosions.
Boss, we got bad guys inbound.
How many we got?
I think that's one of a few moments that the game actually calls your enemies bad guys. I find it very interesting. Usually manages to avoid that. Oh no. See, kind of like a second Modern Warfare as well. Somewhere up there you can actually see the gunship that's about to fire where I just threw the smoke. There it is up there. I like that being able to see what causes it doesn't just come out of the sky.
Established, ready for targets.
And you know, we've been the gunship before on other missions.
Roger, Mark.
Of course, then you control the gunship later, I think, of the next mission. And you realize you can do it quite easily without smoke, so it doesn't really make a whole lot of... It's not really consistent, but... Whatever. It gives you something different to do.
Good work.
PTR destroyed.
Adjustments complete. Ready for work. Firing.
Thanks for the assist, Warhammer.
Over here, the entrance to the catacombs.